Hello and welcome back to Bump Love. It's been a tough time for everybody and would like to send you some love while we soldier through it. So we're back with our segment in the DM, where we share your queries, concerns, and worries that you send to our Bump Love inbox so we can get more insight, so you can get more insight from us and our viewers. So today we have a troubled parent, and this is what she sent to our DM. Hello, Bump Lovers. My 22-month-old daughter likes touching her private parts. Whenever she removes her diaper, she wants to pat her legs and touch herself. And she seems to enjoy it. It's really worrying me. I slap her hand and tell her it's bad to touch, but she repeats the act. Has anyone experienced this? And what did they do? And no, I don't think it's the maid touching her. So yes, let's help our troubled mom.
So I'll go first. No, I have not experienced this. I don't have a daughter and I've not seen this with my son, but I'm just speaking from a research point of view. Believe it or not, there's a lot of information on Google. But when I first heard your predicament, my first thought was, gosh, if that were me, I'd be beside myself, but I'll definitely seek the help of a pediatrician or a counselor, somebody who has sort of dealt with this sort of thing. And it's not as uncommon as you might think, so I don't think that you are alone, because there's lots of information about how you can support your child through it. The good news is, which I found extremely strange, is that it is normal. It's a normal thing that happens amongst children as they try and discover their bodies and their identity and what their bodies are like. So touching is part of exploring, it's part of discovery. And so you should rest in that fact that it's normal. But there is things that you need to do to support your child through this natural or normal thing that happens with your child. And one of them I discovered is teaching modesty. So guide this discovery, your self-discovery, by teaching modesty at a very young age. And by that I mean show them that, you know, learning about their bodies is a special thing and that your body deserves respect. So things like dressing should be done in a bedroom or in a bathroom. Don't allow them just to, you know, dress wherever they want to, starting from a very young age. So even when you're like changing diapers, or because I think at 22 months the child is probably walking now, direct them to a bathroom or a bedroom to show that this is where we dress up from. And so if you want to do self-discovery, you do it from this side, not in public, not at the dining table, not in the living room, you know, where visitors are, where the rest of the family is sitting. And then the other thing that I found profound was don't shame them, because like you mentioned, you slap their pants, stop what you're doing, you know, because it's a natural thing for them to discover themselves. What you need to do perhaps is provide a distraction. They were saying that the difference between this sort of touching and what happens with adolescents is that kids can easily be distracted. So I would advise that you find a distraction, but not in a shameful way, not in a what you're doing is wrong, you know, just sort of remove her hand and offer her a toy, or, you know, point her in the direction of something that will distract her.
What I've studied about children is they also start to have, you know, body awareness, like they explore their bodies, just the way they will touch their nose and ears. So even their privacy, they are simply exploring their body parts. And it's something absolutely normal, like you said, Rachel, something not to cause an alarm. But of course, like every parent, when you see your child do it consistently, it starts to worry you. But just to stay calm, I think, yeah, like you said, one of our guests that come, you know, give us lots of advice that we also take home is, you know, that panic as parents, eh? Also, it's really, really unnecessary sometimes. So just to calm down and just understand that it's a phase that will run out. But then for them to understand, you know, that it's okay, or if you want to teach them about, you know, their privates and how to stay safe, I've learned that the best time to do it is, you know, when maybe you're taking them to bed, or at a moment when you're giving them a bath, like it's a right time to tell them, yeah, this is your private. No one should touch your private parts. I have a girl now, but I'm very particular at moments when maybe I'm dressing her up. I make sure the boys are not really aware. Actually, one of them was telling me the other day, oh my God, Zara doesn't have a susu like us. So, you know, they're also just getting to understand, they're just children. But I try to not expose her to the boys when she's dressing up or when she's bathing, she'll bathe away from them, because I know they need to understand that a girl is different from a boy, but not at that level where, you know, they even get to touch and all that. So I ensure that that is really kept private for her. For the boys, actually, one of my sons had that habit. One of my boys had that habit growing up, and he used to do it while sucking his finger. And someone was telling me, you know, it's something that soothes, like it's something that calms them down and soothes them. But then I would, instead of beating the finger, because when you beat, they, you know, they are more anxious. They're like, why am I being beaten? We just kept talking him out. Oh, don't do that. A big boy like you, how do you do that? And then eventually, I think it sinks in their brain, and they stop. But telling children about this at an early age is something very, very important. It's important that they know it when they're much younger, so that when they grow up, they appreciate their sexuality better. It's not something they are, you know, hiding away from. They understand exactly what's going on when they grow older. And study shows that many people that have learned about it younger will appreciate it, and they don't do it, like, it's not like the kids that will run away and go and do it while they're hiding because they know they're doing something bad. So it's that education that I think every child needs to know at an early age. But I think it's a phase that passes. Just talk the child out, and eventually they'll stop.
Actually, yeah, I think Rachel's spoke to this before about private parts exploration, and I think it's private part exploration really is, it's a normal part of childhood development. It's just more pronounced in some than in others. And I mean, even us as adults, like, you'll have something tickling your ear, and then you'll get like a cotton bud, and then you you get some relief from when you've rubbed inside your ear, but you still continue to kind of wax out the ear, not because you need to, but because there's some sort of pleasure that you derive. And it's just not human nature. When you're pleasured, you want to continue. Sit chop, yes. The only issue here, and where I think the discomfort lies, is in the part that the pleasure is being derived from. And for this case, unfortunately, it's the privates. So I think that's what's troubling the parent, which is a valid discomfort. But I think that the same way you teach or guide your children on what is good as they grow is the same way that you help them understand that their private parts, that touching their private parts like that is kind of inappropriate. But because there'll come a time when it is okay to touch. It's just not in public. So I tell, don't scare them, you know that, but I don't. They'll grow up when it is even that time for them, when it is okay to touch, they'll even fear. But I think the important thing to understand right now is that all factors constant, it is not abnormal behavior. It's just inappropriate. And with some guidance from an adult, it can be managed. So, you know, we have a resident Kafulu in these matters. The issue really here is how do you, because, you know, you can't speak to an under 2-year-old, because it's easy to say this issue is in a 5-year-old and you talk to them, tell them this is a private, tell them you can communicate. But now we have somebody who cannot talk, who you can't really talk to. And I read that this even starts as young as months old, like 2 months old. So our resident Kafulu is here with us, Yunya, our resident host Kafulu. And maybe she can help us, take us through what this mom can do, especially with the younger babies who don't talk or understand spoken communication yet. Child Amulondo, over to you.
Over to me, resident Kafulu. Wow. Anywho, so first of all, like you so rightly said, Pumla, like almost all the advice we've given is for kind of older children. This is a child who's under the age of 2, as you're not going to tell them, actually, this is not appropriate, do it in private. Like, you really can't tell them. But one of the things that you said that I want to reiterate is the fact that, one, it's normal. It's like how what Rosette was saying, it's like finding your nose, finding your ears, finding, and then like Pumla said, if you find a spot that's really sweet and nice, you kind of repeat it. I personally have this thing where I have something in between my nail and my finger. And when I pull it out, the pleasure is so good. I intentionally cause that to myself because I find pleasure. So you're so right that that thing. So when they find pleasure, yes, they will continue it. And we found that there's places when children are most likely going to touch their genitals and therefore find pleasure. So it's like when they are sucking their fingers, when they're going to bed at night, when they're bored, when they're going to shower, when you're changing diapers, because there's access. So first of all, for us, for you, for the mom, for Mommy Anonymous to realize that, one, it's normal because it's a part on their body. Two, they are going to want to explore like every other child. They will explore their environment, what's outside of them and what's on them. For them, that genital is like a nose. And we need to realize that we can't be so intoxicated with the bad of this world that we think that a 2-year-old has come and said, now I'm going to touch my genitals, and so I am now going to find pleasure, and then I'm going to continue doing it over and over again because I find pleasure. You know, that's really not how it works. For them, it's like a nose that they found something pleasurable, and so they are continuing it. So for the mom to have to settle down, to calm down and have relax, it is them, they found a nose, a pleasurable nose. That's how you should take it. It only becomes, and I mean, in our EC, I don't want to go so deep in ECD, I really don't want to, but Sigmund Freud talked about it. There's 5 stages in a child's psychosexual development that leads to their personality. I personally don't subscribe to that, to his, and I mean, it's contentious. Even in ECD, we find what he said very contentious, but it does make sense in certain ways. But there's a phallic stage when a child is 3 to 6 years, when they find a certain interest in their genitals, in people's genitals, on TV, they are interested. They are like, the genitals now start to make sense. Before, they don't really. It's when they are 3 to 6 that they're like, this. So if a child is 3 to 6 and they start to find pleasure at that time, now you can get really, really worried because they can start masturbation as early as 3 to 6 years. So that's the time when you want to be scared. But for now, she has just found her nose. That's it. And it's pleasurable. So what can you do as a mom? As a mom, one, you need to distract your child. And I say this over and over and over again to moms. Do not change a child's diaper if you're not talking to the child. Talk to the child, look them in the eye. As long as you're looking at a child in the eye, you're enough distraction. Ask them, how are you? How was your day? I'm now going to do this. I'm going to remove your diaper. Now I've removed it. Good, you pooped. Now I've removed the poop. I'm going to use a wipe. It's called talk to your child. You're the first distraction for your child. So that means you're not talking to your child. You're just going through the motions, remove the diaper, and put through. Then when you come back, they've parted their legs and put the hand. So talk with your child through the process of changing the diaper. 2, give your child a toy. Give them something to hold on to. Give them something to put in their mouth. Give them something that holds both of their hands. But that's if a child is touching themselves while doing diaper change. Maybe they're touching themselves while they suck their finger. Give them a blankie so that they touch the blankie, or give them your hand. Give all they're looking for is just something to soothe them. So give them something else, distract them, give them something else that will give them that same pleasure that they would get if they're putting their hand on their genitals.
Thank you so much. Yeah, Manuela, that for me sounds around right, because I think that last part, I was trying to do a lot of reading, and I think that's really what the more important part in managing and guiding is to just try to remove that, to reduce that pleasure so that they don't keep doing it. So yes, our troubled mom, I think the most important thing to highlight again is that it is normal because this is a part of their body and they just want to explore their body. And this is a good thing. They found a nose. So mom, relax, Bambi. Just take note of the advice that has been shared, implement and monitor. What I can tell you right now is good luck. I do hope we've been of help. And you know, this is to our viewers, anyone who can offer some further help or advice or guidance, please use the comment section below. And you know, to enjoy your parenting journey even more, share with us your questions or your troubles with us, your concerns in a DM. There's always someone with the perfect solution or combination of solutions for you. Remember, mom life ain't bad life. Mothering ain't suffering. Until next time, with love from Bumpy Love.